In a previous heading, we had understood about the force and levers, types of levers. There are three types of levers, that is first, second and third type of levers. How they work, and it has been related to the sports, physical education, and it is very important for or in a physical education to understand about these types of levers and counterweight of levers. Now we are trying to understand the heading of today's lecture, that is based on equilibrium, dynamic and static and center of gravity and their application in sports. Dynamic and static center of gravity. In our lower classes, we had understood about the gravity, that is related. We only came to know about, and when we talk about the center of gravity, immediately a picture forms in our mind related to a globe, or we are talking something related to our world. But many of you are unable to understand that center of gravity plays an important role in physical education also. It is very important to understand the role of center of gravity and its application, how it can be applied. How it can be applied in physical education. Equilibrium. What is equilibrium? When all forces acting on the body and counterbalanced by equal and opposite force. Here we are talking about when we are doing some physical activity. Suppose we are running. We have a force that is applied while running 100 meter race, so that the sum of force equal 0. It is called the state of equilibrium. It also can be said that equilibrium occurs when the resultant force acting on a point is 0. The sum of force is 0. The state of equilibrium occurs when the body center of gravity is over the base of support and the line of gravity falls within the base. I would like to give you one example related to equilibrium. Every day we are sitting somewhere, sitting on a ground, sitting on a chair. While we are sitting, we have noticed that the position has a larger base or support. While we are sitting, I am sitting in a chair, the base of that chair or base of my body become larger. Base support than the standing position. Sitting position, the base of sitting position is larger than a position while we are standing. Understand, class? that is the force that is applied while sitting, and we sit straight because the base, if there, what will happen? If there will be not a proper base, what will happen? You are unable to sit comfortably, or you may fall, or you will be unable to feel comfortable while sitting. There are two types of equilibrium. One is static and second is dynamic. Static means when the center of gravity is a stable position, in a stable position. Suppose before running 100 meter sprint, you had seen the command is given on your map, set. What the athletes do? They prepare themselves, but they are not running. We have to understand this. They are not running. They are in a stable position. They focus on a track and prepare themselves for the whistle or a gunshot to trigger, then they start running. At that time, they are in a rest position. They are in a stable position. And opposite is dynamic. We can understand dynamic. The center of gravity is in motion. While running, I had given you example, a beautiful example of athletic. On your mark, set, is in static, but as soon as you start running, you are in motion. And within running lies our center of gravity. You had seen while taking part in annual sports day, while running, some of the students, they suddenly fell down and hurt themselves. Yes or no? Yes. You had seen it. Suddenly they fell down and they hurt themselves. Why they are falling, or why they had fallen down and hurt themselves? Sometimes we make many excuses, but the reason behind that is the center of gravity. Center of gravity. So static and dynamic is cleared. Principle of stability. We had came to know about type of equilibrium. There are two types of equilibrium, static and dynamic. One is in a rest position or a stable position. Second is in motion position while we are doing or moving something in a physical education, sports and games. Principle of stability. What is stability? In sports and games, stability is usually referred to a balance. In gymnastics, is totally based on balance. The body's ability to maintain stability or balance is governed by the following principles. All these things have a scientific reason, and those are scientific principles. Without वी आर अनेबल टू परफॉर्म और गिव आर बेस्ट इन फिजिकल एजुकेशन वाइल टेकिंग पार्ट. फर्स्ट इज द लोअर ऑफ सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी इज बेस्ड ऑन सपोर्ट. सो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट प्रिंसिपल ऑफ स्टेबिलिटी एंड वी हैड सीन इट रेफर्स और यूजली इन कॉमन सेंस वी से कॉमन लैंग्वेज वी से एज अ बैलेंस. सो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ग्रेविटी द सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी. द लोअर द सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी इज द बेस ऑफ सपोर्ट. वॉट यू अंडरस्टैंड बाय दिस स्टेटमेंट द ग्रेटर इज स्टेबिलिटी. हियर आई एम सिटिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ अ टेबल एंड द बेस और अ सपोर्ट ऑफ दिस टेबल इज very vast. So the greater is stability. It is not falling down this side, not falling that side. It is stable, stable, stability. But when we are talking about physical education, one of the important example is a shot putter also involves bending the knee to prevent fouling at the time of follow through. Or while running, you had seen the athlete little bit tilt his body, little bit curve his body to the forward. As the center of gravity is below our lower limbs, it is very beneficial for us for stability. If our center of gravity goes up while running, suddenly you fall down. Shot putter, lower the knees. You know how to handle shot put or while taking part. You gently bend your knees because at that time you are counterweighting the gravity. You are getting a bigger surface to stand and throw that iron ball. The nearer the center of gravity is to the center of base or support, the more stable is the body. When the center of gravity extends beyond the boundaries of the base support, the balance is lost. Here, while taking part in PT or free hand exercise, we always say to stretch your arms or stand in a one leg. While standing in a one leg, some people they do like this, they do like this, because they are unable to maintain their center of gravity. As it is near and close to our body, the surface will be bigger, so you will be stable, you will not fall down. That is the meaning of nearer center of gravity, nearer to our body. Stability can be increased by widening the base or support. How we can increase the center of gravity? While sitting on a chair, while you are sitting in a class, you had seen the bench or a chair, the base is widened, base is bigger, and you sit comfortably.
If the base is narrow, you will unable to sit comfortably, you will fall down. For activities where stance is required, using both hands and feet creates the widest base. In assembly, we give to commands, stand at ease or attention. In attention position, the base is narrower. As soon as we give command to stand at ease, your base become wider and you stand comfortably. So this is about the application, how we applied the center of gravity in various form of sports and games. While doing exercise, our center of gravity is between our lower, upper and lower limbs. And what is center of gravity? A center of gravity is an imaginary point around which the body or object is balanced. That is within or outside the body or object. So we had come to know about the importance of center of gravity.